Hello students, so next we will continue with other parameters in terms of y. Similarly, after that we will have other parameters in terms of h and other parameters in terms of t. So right now, other parameters in terms of y. So we want to find out how y parameter can be used to find out the other parameters basically. Okay, so how do we write the y parameters? The y parameters are written as in terms of I. So I1 is equal to y11 v1 plus y12 v2, and I2 is y21 v1 plus y22 v2. Okay, now we have to solve for the case of z parameter. So z parameter is given by v1 is equal to z11 I1 plus z12 I2, and similarly v2 is given by z1 21 I1 and z22 I2. So actually we should have written it the other way. So I have to write the y parameter here, and the z parameter has to be written here. So this one will be v1 is equal to z11 I1 plus z12 I2, and v2 will be equal to z21 I1 plus z22 I2. So we have to go from here to here. Okay, that means we have to get everything in terms of z in terms of y. Okay, so we will start. So again, see here v1, v2 are the two unknowns for this simultaneous equation, and here that is the solution. So we can use directly the Cramer's law. So using Cramer's law. So Cramer's law, in Cramer's law we can find out v1 as, in the top we will have I1 I2 multiplied, and this side we will have y12 y21, and in the denominator we will have delta y. I will right now write delta y, because delta y is y11 into y1 to y22 and y21 into y12. So this can be written as y21 into I1 minus y12 into I2 divided by delta y, from which I can write y21 divided by delta y into I1 minus y12 divided by delta y into I2. Similarly, v2 is going to be equal to y11, y21, and this is I1, I2, I1, I2, and this is going to be delta y, and this can be written as y11 I2 minus y21 I1 divided by delta y. And since I wanted I1 to be in the front, so I will write minus y21 by delta y I1 plus y11 divided by delta y I2, correct? So in that way I can write, therefore v1 is going to be equal to, let me rewrite it, y21 delta y, from here I am taking it from here, y21 delta y into I1 minus y12 into delta y I2. This is the first one, And the second equation will be with respect to v2, which I will take it from here. v2 is equal to minus y21 by delta yi1 plus y11 by delta yi2. And this I will put in the second box, and this is going to be. So based on this, from this I can get, therefore, the z parameter. Now, why I am saying that this is going to be the z parameter? Because this is the equation that I have now got here. Look in the box. So it is based on v1 and v2 with respect to i1 and i2. So this is the same thing. So from here directly I can write, now you can see delta y is common here. So 1 by delta y I will take outside, and the remaining I will put. So it will be, just wait, I have made some mistake here. Sorry, this should have been y22. So this is y22, this is also y22, and this side it's going to be y22. So this one will be y22 minus y12, this will be minus y21, and this will be y11, which is actually the whatever is the y, the inverse of that. Okay, so I can again write here that with respect to the z parameter can be written in terms of y as, yeah, so this is going to be 1 divided by delta y22 minus y12 minus y21 and y11. And next we will have to do for the case of h parameter, how h parameter can be written in terms of y, how h parameter can be written in terms of y. So if you have got some h parameter, how from that h parameter we will be able to get, if you have got y parameter, from that how will be able to find out the h parameter. Okay, so in terms of y, so again let us look at the equation of h parameter. The equation of h parameter, here it is given, it is v1 and i2 with respect to h11, sorry, with respect to i1 and v2. So v1 and i2 with respect to i1 and v2. So let us write it. So if I want, I can write it here. So the B part is h parameter in terms of y parameter. So we know the equation. The equation is of h parameter is with v1 and i2 with respect to i1 and v2 with respect to i1 and v2. So here it is h11, h12, h21, h22. I will start with the y parameter. The y parameter is, the y parameter is written as vi, so it is going to be i1 and i2 with respect to v1 and v2 with respect to v1 and v2. So if I have to take from here, if I have to go from here to here, see in the second equation, if you would look, the second equation I will have with respect to this one, if you would see, i2 is there, v2 is there, v2 is here. What has to be replaced is v1 with i1. So v1 can be replaced by looking from the top. So let me name the equations. So this will be equation number 1A, and this will be equation number 1B. and this I can write as equation number 2a, and this can be written as 2b. So therefore, from 2a I will get y11v1 as i1 minus y12v2, or v1 as 1 by y11 i1 minus y12 by y11 v2. This I will name it as equation 3. And next I will put 3 in 2b. So if I am going to put equation, so I will get i2 is equal to y21 v1. V1 is 1 divided by y11 i1 minus y12 divided by y11 v2 plus y12 v2, from where I can take i1 components together, so I will get i2. Therefore, let me do it here itself. So if I take i1 together, it will be y21 by y11 i1, and whatever is v2, so I will write plus y12 minus y21 y12 divided by y11 into the whole into v2, which now I can write it as, therefore i2 is going to be y21 divided by y11 i1, okay, and then we are having the remaining part, which I can write it as cross multiplying let me see if I have made any mistake. Small mistake is there. This is y22. I have written it as y1, so this will be y22. So this will be y22 into y11 minus y21 into y12 divided by divided by y11 divided by y11 into v2, from which I can get, therefore i2 is equal to y21 divided by y11 i1 plus, this is going to be delta y divided by y11 into v2. This I will put in a box. Similarly, this also I will put in a box. Now this I can name it as equation number 4, and this also I can put in a box, and this I can name it as equation number 3. So now see, equation number 3 is matching with equation number 1a, and this equation is directly matching with equation 1b. Okay, that's in terms of i1 v2. So now what I am going to do is, I am going to write based on this what is going to be my h11 and the other value. So I will write the h parameter is going to be, so as you can see, y11 is common in denominator, so I will write y11 as common, and the remaining from first one I will get 1 minus y12, this is going to be y21, and this is delta y, correct? So let me write this here. So it is going to be 1 divided by y11, this is going to be 1, this is going to be delta y, this is minus of minus of y12, and this is going to be y21. So this is the h parameter in terms of y parameter. So if you already know y parameter, you can directly find h parameter by this. Okay, next, similarly, I have to go for the t parameter and find out it in terms of. So what is the equation of t? T is basically v1 i1 with respect to v2 i2, isn't it? So this is the equation v1 i1 with respect to v2 i2. Remember, in ABCD parameter or Z parameter, it is negative in between. So if I am going to take this equation and now, so this is going to be the C part. So this is t parameter in terms of y parameter. So first I will write here what is the t parameter. T parameter is v1 and i1 with respect to v2 and i2. Correct? So let me again check. So it is correct. V1 and I1 with respect to V2 and I2. So now, based on this, if I am going to calculate, so the Y parameter, first I will write the Y parameter. The Y parameter is I1 with respect to V1 and with respect to V2. Similarly, I2 with respect to V1 and with respect to V2. Now take a look at this equation. This I will name it as 1A, this I will name it as 1B, this I will name it as 2A, this I will name it as 2B. Now let us look at the equation. As you can see, the only equation that will match in these two is 2A and 1B. So I am having I1, here also there is I1, there is a V2, there is a V2, but instead of a V1, I am having I2. Okay, and that I2 I can directly substitute from the second equation. So what I will do is, I will substitute I2, so let me write it like this, put 2B in 2A. So what is 2A? I1 plus, wait, I1 is there, V2 is there, yeah, put, I will not write this one. So first I have to find V1. So from 2B, from 2B, I will get V1 is going to be equal to I2, or first I will write V2 in terms of V2. So from 2B I can get minus of y22 v2 divided by y21 and plus 1 divided by y21 i2. This I have got from 2B, or you know, some of you may find it difficult how I have got this, so let me break it up again in steps. So from 2B I will get y21 v1 is equal to I2 minus y22 v2, and since in this equation always v2 is in the front, I will take v2 in the front, therefore v1, and I will take y21 in the other side, and I have to take this one in the front, so minus y22 v2 divided by y21 plus 1 divided by y21 into i2. Okay, this I will put in a box because this equation is matching with 1a. So anyway, this equation I will put in box. Let me write this as equation number 3. I'll put 3 in, put 3 in 2b, not 2b, 2a. Okay, put 3 in 2a. So 2a is i1 is equal to y11, now v1 is what? Minus y22 y21 v2 plus 1 by y21 i2, and then plus y12 v2. From where I can write the v2 components together, therefore i1 is equal to, if I write the v1 components together, then I will get minus of y11 y22 divided by y21 plus y12 the whole into v2 plus 1 divided by, not 1, y11 divided by y21 into i2. From where if I do the cross multiplication, you can see the cross multiplication will come as minus y11 y22 plus y12 y21, which is actually what? Which is actually delta y. So I can write this as, i1 is equal to delta y divided by y21 into v2 plus y11 divided by y21 into i2. Correct? So based on that I can put it in a box, and that becomes my equation number 4. Now comparing 1 with, you know, if I am trying to compare 1a with 3, equation number 3, and equation number 4 with 1b, what will I get? Therefore, I will get the t parameter in terms of y parameter as you can see y21 I can take it as common, and then the remaining portion is minus of y22. Then here if you can see this is negative and this is positive, so I will get minus 1. This is delta y, and this side it is going to be minus y11. Okay, so this is what we are having as the t parameter in terms of y. This is the t parameter in terms of y, and as you can see, let me see if I have missed anything. Yeah, this is minus delta y. This one should be minus delta y. So here again it will come as minus. Sorry. Okay. So this is the t parameter in terms of y parameter. So this I can now write in the table. So t parameter is in terms of, this thing will be 1 divided by 1 divided by y21, and the matrix will be y22 minus 1 minus delta y and minus y11. So as we can see, this column is also completed. Next, we have to go for the other parameters in terms of h. Okay, so that I will do quickly. So this is the third one. Other parameters in terms of H, in which the first one is Z parameter in terms of H parameter. So first I have to write the Z parameter. The Z parameter will be, and the H parameter will be given by, it is in terms of V1 I2. I have also named the equations. Therefore, from 2B, I can get the value of V2 as minus of H21 I1 divided by H22 plus 1 divided by H22 V2. Not V2, sorry, I2. This, let me put it in box, because this is matching with my equation 1b. Anyway, this is going to be my equation number 3. Put 3 in 2a. That becomes v1 is equal to h11 i1 plus h12, and instead of v2 I will write minus h21 by h22 i2 plus 1 by h22 I, so this is I1 and this is I2. So if I write the I1 components together, therefore V1 is equal to H11 minus H12 H21 divided by H22 into I1 plus H12 by H22 into I2, which can be now written as V1 is equal to, if I cross multiply here, I will get on top delta H divided by H22 into I1 plus H12 divided by H22 into I2. This I can put in box. And this is going to be my equation number 4. And now comparing equation number 3 with this, and equation number this one with this first equation, I will get the value of z11, z12 and all. So therefore I will get z as you can see, 1 by h22 is common to all terms, so that I will take out, and I will here get delta H12 minus H21 and 1 minus H21 and 1. So this is the Z parameter in terms of H parameter. Okay, so this we have to write it here. So Z parameter in terms of H parameter will be 1 by H22, and within the matrix we will be having delta H. This is going to be H12, this is minus H21, and this is going to be 1. Okay. Next we have to find Y in terms of H. So next is B part. Y parameter in terms of H parameter. So again, we can take the H parameter directly from here. So this is what we get, this is the h parameter, and now y parameter also I have to write. So now if you look from equation 2b, if I am having i2 is there, i2 is there, similarly v2 is there, v2 is there, what is missing is this i1 has to be changed to v1. Okay, so going by that, I will first try to find out what is i1 from this equation. I will try to find out what is i1 from this equation. So from 2a we get i1. So I will always want to keep v1 in front. So v1, 1 divided by h11 v1 minus h12 divided by h11 v2. This I will put in bracket because that is going to be my third equation, which is same as the first equation. Okay, and then put 3 in 2b. So if I am going to put 3 in 2b, I will get i2 is equal to h21, and instead of i1 I can write 1 by h11 minus h12 by h11 v2, this is v1, plus h22 v2. From where I can combine, therefore I will get i2 is equal to, if I combine v1, I will get h21 by h11 v1, and the v2 will be minus of h21 h12 divided by h11 plus h22 into v2, from where you can see directly I can get i2 is equal to h21 divided by h11 v1, and the remaining can be written as delta h divided by h11 v2. This also I will put in box, and this is going to be my equation number 4. This is going to be my equation number 4. And this, so 3 if I am going to compare it with the first equation, and 4 if I am going to compare it with the second equation, I will get therefore the h parameter as not h, the y parameter as, sorry, I will get the y parameter as, I will get 1 by h11, I will get it outside, then I will have 1 minus h12, this is going to be h21, and delta h. This is y parameter in terms of h parameter. So let me write it here. So y parameter in terms of h parameter will be equal to 1 divided by h11, and within bracket I will have 1 minus h12, this is h21, and delta h. So you have to remember this table. Even if you don't remember this table, at least remember the derivation, because see, each of this is very simple derivation. Each of the derivation is very simple, so you can do it. Okay, next is the t parameter, and we all know t parameter is basically connecting v1 i1 with v2 i2, correct? So v1 i1 with v2 i2. So I will go and I will try to solve it here. So the third one is t parameter. T parameter in terms of the y parameter. t parameter in terms of the y parameter. Okay, let me see if it is y parameter or t parameter in terms of h parameter. No, it's in terms of h parameter, sorry, in terms of h parameter. So what are the t parameters? It is, I have to again, it is v1 and i2 with respect to, sorry, v1 i1 with respect to v2 and i2. This is equation 1a and this is equation 1b, and here what we are having is t parameter, sorry, h parameter. H parameter is again given by v1 and i2 in terms of i1 and plus h12 i1 and v2. So h21 i1 plus h22 v2. Let me check if I'm correct. Yeah, okay. So now this one I will name it as 2a and this one I will name it as 2b. If you would look the first, yeah, so I have to find out I1, so therefore from 2b I1 is going to be equal to h minus h22 by h21 v2, sorry, plus 1 divided by h21 i2. This I will put it in the bracket, and this is my equation number 3. Then put 3 in, put 3 in equation number 2a. So I will get v1 is equal to h11 minus h22 by h21 v2 plus 1 divided by h21 i2 plus h12 v2. From there I can get, therefore v1 is equal to minus of h22 h11 divided by h21 plus h12 v2 and plus h11 by h21 I2. Therefore V1 can be told as, this is minus delta H by H21 into V2 plus H11 divided by H21 into I2, which again I will put it in box, sorry, and now I can compare these two equations. This is equation number 4. This I will compare with the first equation and this I will compare with the second equation. So based on that, therefore I will get the t parameter with respect to h as 1 divided by h21. So this is going to be the first equation, so it will be delta minus delta h, it will be minus delta h, then I have to remember it is minus b, isn't it? This equation is minus here, so I have to take care of that. So minus h11, then minus h22 and minus 1. Okay, so this I will write it here. So it is going to be, let me use the color, 1 divided by h 2 1, and within brackets I am going to have minus delta h minus h 1 1 and minus h 2 2, and this is going to be minus 1. Okay, so it's the same as this one. Yeah, correct. So now I have even done for the h column. Now for the t column, I will leave it as the worksheet for you to do today. So you can find out the last, the teeth column, and I will write the equation for you to see if you have got it correctly. So the first thing that we do is we are having z in terms of t. Z in terms of t will come as 1 divided by c, 1 divided by c, and within brackets I will have a delta t, and here it will be 1 and d. Okay, similarly with respect to y, I will get it as 1 divided by b, and within bracket I will get d minus delta t, then minus 1 and a. Okay, minus 1 and a. Then in h I will get, in h, for the case of h parameter, I will get in terms of t parameter as 1 divided by d, and within matrix I will have b delta t minus 1 and c. So this last column you will have to do as a worksheet today and complete that derivation. As you can see, the derivation is not that difficult. Okay, so thank you. So this we will be now using for doing the problems.